I welcome all of you here at Sabarmati Hostel. We are going to have a public talk on social justice and the Indian Muslims. We have got so many prominent, important intellectuals, activists, authors. They are all going to speak about their own experience. And I am here to just invite them to speak. I am not coming into the way of you and the speakers. But few things I would like to say. In 2014, a new government, the BJP led under Modi, has come to the come to power. And when Congress lost the election, there was a debate that Congress lost not because of its economic policy. Edmund Burke has said once that in a democracy, the majority of the citizens is capable of exercising the most cruel operations upon the minority. And we can see here, be it social and economic realm, politics, human rights, Muslims are at the margin. I will just give you a few statistics to argue this point. The poverty level among Muslim is very high. Muslim community has very low literacy rate. And all the social indicators that they have a very low representation in public sectors. They have high percentage of Muslims in informal sectors. Muslims have highest percentage of high household industrial workers. Muslims are poorer than other religious community. And Muslims are living below the poverty line. These are all the statistics which I have not made and I have not produced. These are all government statistics. Now, when it comes to politics, this government, the BJP, the RSS government, they have completely marginalized Muslims completely. Completely, you cannot think about it. And you will be surprised to know that at current time, there are around 1,380 or 1,400 MLAs. And you know how many Muslims are there? Out of 1,400 BJP MLAs, or maybe BJP's allies MLA, the Muslims are only four. This is the state of our democracy. And Muslims percentage in parliament is decreasing. Now, when it comes to human rights, you'll find that in bureaucracy, in parliament, they are nowhere, but in jail, they are in higher proportion. For example, Muslims constitute something around 14.2%. This is their population, but in jail, they are 19.4%. Besides that, you know that how their basic fundamental rights, human rights, are being violated under the issues of cow protection, lynching, terror charges, demonizing, othering of the Muslim society. This is the situation. Now, what is the way out? Way out is not very simple, because Muslims community is not monolithic. Muslims community is also divided on caste, class, region, and region. For example, a large proportion of Muslims are Pasmanda, they are Ajlaf, they are Arzal, but when it comes to their representation at higher educational institutes and other places, they are not proportionally represented. Now, and Sacher committee and other reports have also said very clearly that Muslims are not the same in every region. Muslims condition in Uttar Pradesh, Muslims condition in Kerala, West Bengal, these are very, very different. They have their different experience. Their political formations, their political alliance is also very different. The way we understand Muslim politics in Uttar Pradesh, we cannot understand Muslim politics in the same way in Kerala. These are the reality. That is why what should be the way ahead is not easy. And we have got very important people here on the dais to speak about their own experience. And we have aptly formed the topic that social justice and Muslims. For example, there is a question of caste, there is a question of class, there is a question of poverty, there is a question of terror charges, there is a question of harassment, there is a question of demonization. And then, what is the philosophy? What is the philosophy of social justice? Is there any need to think afresh? These are all the challenges, and 2019 is not far away from us. The Hindutva politics is already mobilizing people on Ram Temple, on love jihad, and all these issues. So how to think collectively, how to find way out, to know more about it, to understand these issues, we have invited Somu sir from Arts and Aesthetic, JNU, you know him. Umakant sir was earlier the PhD student at Center for Political Studies. He had submitted his PhD on Dalit human rights issues in Bihar. Aiyub Rayeen Saab is our special guest. He is from Bihar and he is a teacher. And he has not taught at university, but his contribution is very major. He has written a book, Bharat Ke Dalit Musalman, and we should know more about him. Then Meeran Haider Saab is also with us. Meeran is at present doing his study at Jamia Millia Islamia, but he is at the forefront of leading a student movement there, and he sat on the hunger strike for so many days to press the demand that a student should have their right to form union. And we have Rajeev. Rajeev is with Rihai Manch. You all know that what Rihai Manch is doing in Uttar Pradesh. It is bringing the issue of framing of the Muslims and how Muslims under the larger discourse of the war on terror is jailed and how they are thrown into the state of complete fear. So Rajeev will be talking about his own experience. And now my friend Badre Alam is also with us. Badre Alam has written his MPhil on Pasmanda movement, and he in PhD, he is currently doing his PhD at Jamia at Delhi University, and he is thinking about political theory, Pasmanda movements and minority rights. So we have got people from a different background. They have a lot to say, but I will ask all of you speakers, I will request all of you that we have very limited time, so we have to be very precise. Tanveer Fazal from Sociology Center, he's also joining us in 5 or 10 minutes. So I would like to first of all invite Somu sir. He will be talking about the philosophy of the social justice. He has written a very wonderful piece on Ambedkar, and he has been the part of the debate and discussions. So he will philosophically first tell us that what is good and what is wrong with the social justice politics. So I first invite Somu sir to speak.